First, we will install the MLVA plugin in our BioNumerics database. We call the plugin dialog box and select the MLVA plugin. Press Activate and confirm the installation. New database components will be added, so you need administrator privileges to continue. A new menu item is added to the main window. Next, we will import VNTR sequencer curve files in this database. Press the Import button and under Fingerprint Type Data, choose Import Curves. Next, we browse for the files . We select them and click Open. In the next dialog, we find two default import templates listed. The first one will parse entry keys from the file name, and the second one will parse entry keys as well as pools from the file name. For the present dataset, the key and pool information is provided within the file name of the curve files. Pressing the Preview button gives us an idea of how the data will be parsed. The parsed key is OK, but the pool name may be shorter. The number after the hyphen is not informative. I can adjust this by clicking Edit. Here I select the fingerprint pool, show the advanced options, and go to Edit Parsing. I add a hyphen and an asterisk to the parsing string. And I press Preview to verify the adjustment. In the template dialog, I go back to the preview and now see the pool names will be parsed correctly. In the next step, you can select the dyes you want to import and indicate which dye is used for the internal reference. Next, we choose to link the data to the entries by means of the key field, and we click Finish. I have no fingerprint types present yet in this database, so the import wizard will create a new one, and I enter a name for it. For each pool and dye combination, a fingerprint type needs to be present in the database. The names of these fingerprint types are composed of the base fingerprint type name, followed by the pool name and the name of the dye. If one of these fingerprints is not present in the database, this dialog box will warn me and allows me to confirm their creation. A warning pops up saying that I'm about to perform a fundamental action on the database setup. This action will be the creation of new fingerprint experiment types. Please note that you need administrator privileges to do so. The plugin checks if the keys are already present in the database. If not, new entries are created. Enabling this checkbox will automatically open the imported data in the pre-processing window. The software now splits the curve files into separate fingerprint files per imported dye. The individual lanes are assigned to their appropriate fingerprint type and linked to the corresponding entries. The fingerprint curve processing window opens. All channels are loaded and displayed. Since the raw chromatogram files have not undergone any pre-processing, normalization will have to be performed. This requires a reference system to be defined based upon the marker peaks available in the reference dye. Make sure the reference dye is the only one visible in the upper panel by unchecking the sample channels in the below panel. Click the Search Reference Bands button leave the default settings, and click OK. The bands that fall within the specified criteria are marked with a solid line at the band's position. To have a reference system automatically created based on a lane containing a commercial size marker, first highlight a suitable lane and select References Defined Size Standard. I select the GeneScan 500 LIS, select Pattern Match and press OK. For the calibration information to become available, we save the data to the database. I confirm the increased normalized track resolution. To normalize a complete run at once, press Auto Assign Reference Positions, All Lanes. I leave the settings unaltered and I press OK. Now the data can be shown in normalized mode. I will now show the data channels and hide the reference channel from the view. Press Search Data Bands. Here I check Remove Doublets, Remove Shadow Bands, and I will filter by fragment length. I specify a minimum length of 50 and press OK. All VNTR bands of interest were found. Now we can close the fingerprint curve processing window. In the main window, we see that all entries now have experimental data for all newly created fingerprint types. Clicking on a colored dot will open the respective curve window.